Euro weakens as a result of Italian uncertainty. Theresa May calls for unity within her party. Dollar rallies off the back of Fed Chair's comments. The big talking point for the pound last week was on Thursday when Theresa May gave her keynote speech at the annual Conservative Party conference. She talked of the need for unity amongst her party and that further infighting could jeopardise Brexit negotiations. Whilst May did not specifically mention her Chequers proposal, she was conscious of mentioning the need for a free trade agreement that allowed for the frictionless movement of goods. She seemed conscious of not rocking the boat, and during her speech the pound was little changed. On Friday the pound rallied as optimism grew regarding negotiations and especially around the Irish border. There were talks that both sides were prepared to make concessions and that if no agreement could be made, that there was a possibility that the UK could still operate within the EU customs union. On the economic data front last week, both the UK manufacturing PMI and services PMI showed figures above 50, which is positive and indicate growth. However, both surveys did report that Brexit uncertainty and the lack of optimism regarding an outcome was causing a drag on growth. The British Chamber of Commerce also found similar findings in its survey, noting that Brexit uncertainty had led to increased difficulty in recruitment and also a scaling back of investment plans. Out of the survey, 79% of respondents found that leaving the EU in the long term would make business conditions or their businesses worse off. Last week in the US, Jerome Powell made some interesting comments regarding interest rate expectations. He said interest rates had a long way to go before they were neither restrictive nor accommodative. Over the last decade or so, US interest rates have been historically low in order to accommodate the financial crisis. Whilst they're now going through an interest rate hiking cycle, Powell believes that given where economic growth, unemployment, and inflation are, that essentially interest rates still have a fair bit to go before they are neither accommodative nor restrictive. As a result of these rather hawkish comments, US 10-year Treasury yields hit a 7-year high at almost 3.2%, and the dollar strengthened off the back of his comments. Over in Europe, the ECB expects interest rates to remain unchanged until around summer next year. They also said that their QE program is likely to end by the end of this year. They're quite happy with market expectations that interest rates will likely rise in around the first quarter of 2019. Despite the relatively positive comments from the ECB last week, the euro is under pressure after further concerns were raised around the stability of Italian banks and also the prospect of the new Italian government looking to adopt an expansionary fiscal policy which was outside the EU's mandate. As a result, we saw Italian bonds sold off, the euro weaken, and if this situation further deteriorates, with the Italian banks or the government, we could see the euro weaken off further. With all political developments aside, a relatively quiet week ahead. On Wednesday, we have UK GDP for August, expected to be slightly lower at 0.2%. And on Thursday, we have US inflation, which is expected to be slightly higher and above the Fed's target of 2.3%. Thank you once again for watching this week. Don't forget to like or subscribe our videos. And here at Rational Foreign Exchange, we're here to help businesses and individuals with their foreign currency requirements. So if you have any questions or queries, please feel free to contact us on the links provided.